Welcome to this webinar on the Tai Ji Men case in Taiwan. What is Tai Ji Men? Tai Ji Men is a menpai or a spiritual group teaching Qi Gong, founded by Dr. Hong Taozi in Taiwan in 1966. It is based on the ancient teachings of Taoism, but is not a religion, and it's open to people of all faiths. Actually, I am a Roman Catholic, and when I visited the group in Taiwan, I met students who are themselves Catholics and of many other religions. Now, why is there a problem with Tai Ji Men? Why, when, and how is this group persecuted or discriminated against? Why? Since the imperial era in China, some groups have been labeled as Se Zhao. This is translated as cults, but the translation is not entirely accurate. Se Zhao means heterodox teachings, teachings the government or the politicians, for whatever reasons, do not approve of. This idea of Se Zhao passed from Imperial China to Republican China to mainland China today, and also existed in Taiwan during the martial law era and beyond. So when was Tai Ji Men persecuted? In 1996, for political reasons, there was in Taiwan a crackdown on groups the government regarded as hostile to the politicians in power. Criminal actions were launched. The leader of Tai Ji Men and other people went to jail, but all these criminal actions totally collapsed. Dr. Hong and Tai Ji Men not only were recognized as totally innocent, but even the court ends up apologizing to them for the unfair and unsubstantiated accusation. So how was Tai Ji Men persecuted? A byproduct of the failed criminal action were tax audits. Tai Ji Men were accused of tax evasion, and it was claimed that the offers disciples gave to their master in the so-called red envelopes were not gifts from disciple to master, but were payment for courses in a cram school. Again, this was false, and the highest administrative and control courts and authorities in Taiwan stated that there was no tax evasion, that the accusations were false, that Tai Ji Men was not guilty of tax evasion. Based on these decisions, however, the tax office agreed to reduce to zero the tax bills for Tai Ji Men for all years except year 1992. They claim that for 1992, the appeal terms had expired. But of course, there is no appeal term when decisions are grossly unjust. They can always be revised. In conclusion, what is happening now? Now the tax office is insisting with its bill for 1992 and threatens to seize properties of Tai Ji Men and auction them, which will cause enormous harm to Tai Ji Men and to freedom of belief. It's not about money. Tai Ji Men spent more in legal expenses than what will pay if they paid the tax bill for 92. It's about principle. They didn't commit any wrongdoing, and they don't want to admit this. It will be false. So the world is interested in the Tai Ji Men case. The world is looking at Taiwan. It's about freedom of belief. It's not only about tax justice, although tax justice is important. And this is why today I'm joined by distinguished panelists from all over the world who would also offer their comments on the Tai Ji Men case in Taiwan.